When you compare these prices to last year, we're still paying a dollar more for gas. And as the cost of fuel remains high, so does interest in alternative energy vehicles. In fact, researchers right here in Ohio are on the cutting edge of alternative energy cars that may one day be sitting in your driveway. News 5's Eric Flack has more tonight on how these future fuels and how long it'll be before they hit the mainstream.
Some of the technology is already on the road. Some is still years away. All of it will change the way you drive and how much that ride costs.
You're riding with the research team behind an electric car that has no shortage of power. It's called the Buckeye Bullet. Tested in the salt flats of Utah, the Bullet once hit 315 miles per hour, a world record. On this run, the scientist holding the video camera can barely keep up.
We have the electric, battery-powered electric land speed record.
The Bullet's journey to Utah and into the record books started here, Ohio State University's Center for Automotive Research, a place where alternative energy is the only energy.
You know, $4 a gallon gas is making people angry.
Sean Midler-Moeller is one of the center's research scientists.
It sounds kind of perverse, but we're lucky that the price of gasoline is at the point where now people are seriously starting to say, we need to change.
Here's why. According to the Department of Energy, gas prices steadily declined during the 80s and 90s. Midler-Moeller says that put the brakes on research into alternative energy. But as gas prices started creeping back up, so did interest in finding cars that run on something cheaper.
I step on the gas and we're away.
There we go.
One of the directions researchers are heading is toward hydrogen power cars. I got to drive one when I visited the center. It runs on a hydrogen gas fuel cell and is 100% pollution-free. Instead of ozone-eating gases like CO2, the only thing that goes into the air is H2O.
So the only thing that comes out of the tailpipe there is water.
Right, exactly.
This summer, Honda became the first auto manufacturer to start commercially producing a hydrogen-powered car. But scientists say widespread use of hydrogen fuel is still more than a decade away, in large part because there is no infrastructure to support it. There are only 15 hydrogen refueling stations in the U.S., one of them right here in Columbus.
Are people's expectations a little bit high right now for alternative fuel cars?
I don't think so. There's a lot of people working on alternative energies. The government is investing a lot of money in the research, and there's a lot of things coming.
Some have already arrived. Hybrid gas electric cars are now some of the most popular on the road, with wait lists for the industry-leading Toyota Prius now as long as 9 months. The team at Ohio State says ethanol and biodiesel also have promising futures.
There is no gasoline anymore. There's nothing that's it. I think in the future there's going to be lots of fuels. It's not going to be one fuel. And it's really difficult to say what's going to be on top.
So while the finish line may be hard to see, it's clear the race to get our foot off the gas is speeding up.
The cost of alternative energy cars remains high, in large part because of all the added technology under the hood. But with a recent AP poll showing 9 out of 10 Americans now predict high gas prices will put them in a financial bind over the next year, many are finding paying a little extra at the dealership is worth saving at the pump. Eric Flack, Target 5.